These victims came to us with their stories of horror.
I saw people dying in front of me.
And my kids ask about him a lot.
I look at my hand, I had skin and blood.
Maria Diaz was just 15 when she and her aunt were caught in the crossfire in the 1972 Lode Airport attack in Tel Aviv. Diaz was hit with a grenade. Her aunt, just 6 years older, 21 and newly engaged, was killed.
I would have given anything for that to happen to me, not to her.
After all these years, this is Diaz's first TV interview.
4 minutes, and it changed my whole life.
In the nearly 40 years since, Diaz says she still has pain in her legs, has endured 8 surgeries, and has not seen a penny of the money the U.S. government promised she would get. Money that's supposed to be taken from a $1.5 billion fund set up to compensate victims of Libyan-sponsored terrorism. Instead, what Diaz got was this letter from the U.S. Treasury Department saying she would eventually get a prorated payment, 20% of what she is due.
How much of the money have you seen?
At this point, I haven't seen any.
The problem, say these victims, is that the government miscalculated and that there's not enough money left in the compensation fund for more than 200 victims. An estimated shortfall of $350 million. But the State Department says it's too early to say there will be any shortfall. The State Department would not go on camera, but told CNN, quote, it is premature to determine that there will be a shortage of settlement funds. Roughly half the claims are still being processed.
Some of the money was distributed to some of the victims.
Lockerbie and in LaBelle Disc Attack, which at the time, as you probably recall, were the attacks that most people knew about.
The most high profile.
The most high profile attacks. There were a lot of attacks that most people don't recall.
Like the one in which Jonathan Pollock was injured at the Rome Airport in 1985.
If you were injured, you were entitled to $3 million. If you were killed, $10 million. Your family, of course, for wrongful death.
So you thought, okay, eventually I'll get this money.
I did.
Pollock has received $600,000, but it's 20% of what he's owed.
That's insulting. To say you'll get a prorated amount now and not guaranteeing that you'll get the whole amount later is insulting.
Neither Pollock nor Diaz were among those who sued Libya for damages, but they are entitled to claims from the same fund under a law Congress passed to cover victims of state-sponsored terrorism.
We did fight in federal court.
Alex Alimanestianu was a litigant in the historic case that led to the U.S.-Libyan agreement to compensate victims. He lost his father on UTA Flight 772 when it exploded over the African desert in September 1989. His family has been paid $2 million of the $10 million that was owed to them.
I blame the U.S. government. I mean, clearly they didn't do their homework, and they were rushing to make a deal with the devil. The amount of the money is not really the issue. It's really about justice.
Alina Cho, CNN, New York.